Hello folks, and welcome back to Keep Productive News. Today we're updating you on the latest Microsoft updates from Microsoft Ignite 2020. This video is sponsored by ClickUp. We'll share a little later a bit more about them. So this update is a little bit lengthier because it is all of the updates from the Microsoft event. This update from Microsoft focuses on digital transformation that has been accelerated by COVID-19. Now, apparently, they've estimated that we've navigated the equivalent of a year of digital transformation every month in 2020. So let's start with some of the updates that are coming to Microsoft Teams. So let's focus on the meetings. The first update is called Together Mode. These are new scenes that include auditoriums, conference rooms, and coffee shops, all available later this year. Essentially, presenters will be able to select a scene from the gallery as a default for all meeting attendees to make a more realistic visual experience. So apparently, however close you are to the camera or far away, you'll feel like you're in a coffee shop with other people or other scenes available. So the second change to meetings is they're announcing custom layouts. This is coming later this year, but it will allow presenters to customize how content shows up for participants during a meeting. So for example, if you're hosting a PowerPoint slide, the participants will be able to see the presenter's video feed transposed on the foreground of the slide they're showing. So the third major update to meetings has been the focus on breakout rooms. Now this is something that Zoom has had for a while, and it's been one of the most requested Teams features, and it'll be available next month in October. Meeting organizers will be able to split up participants into smaller groups. This is perfect for discussions, breakout sessions, for example, if you're at an online conference, and other such engagements. You can also, like Zoom, make announcements and updates, close rooms, and bring people back to the main meeting. So something I mentioned here on the channel too, if you're not subscribed here, please do subscribe here on YouTube. They also are pushing and upgrading the new Teams meetings extension, allowing you to integrate applications and enable custom meeting experiences in Teams. So soon, that will be generally available for everyone in October, as they've had a happy and successful launch with 20 partners, including PagerDuty, Range, and ServiceNow. So you should be able to add more apps to Microsoft Teams. So I don't know whether this is a brand new feature or something that has been just slightly modified, but after every meeting in Teams, a recap of the meeting recording, transcription, chat, share files, and more will be automatically created. And the recap will also be available in your Outlook calendar by going to the meeting event. So they're bringing together an associating of meeting recordings with event details and calendar, which is very useful. They're also looking to upgrade and enhance the calling experience with Microsoft Teams, including a streamlined view that shows your contacts, voicemail, and calling history at once. So they are due to come later this year. Microsoft Teams is also getting an infrastructure update when it comes to supporting the amount of meetings. So apparently team meetings are growing to support 1,000 participants with full meeting experience by the end of the year. There are options for larger meetings and events. There is additional control coming, and it will soon be able to host and support 20,000 people in a view-only meeting experience, which is set to include live captions. So apparently this will be available for the customers that are with the new advanced communications plan. So more Teams updates, they're introducing or announcing Microsoft Teams panels. So this is a new category of devices that can be mounted outside a meeting space to notify participants of scheduling and occupancy and to assist a wayfinding around the office. So obviously these are designed to improve safety guidelines for shared spaces, and they have two official panel partners called Creston and Yealink. So they'll be able to give us a bit of a test pilot of how that works. They're also introducing something called the Surface Hub 2S 85-inch model, available for pre-sale reservations in the US customers beginning in January 2021. Apparently this will harness 365 Teams Windows and basically be your Teams hub in the office, allowing you to see useful updates and keep you all updated. So one of the major updates that Microsoft focused on at Microsoft Ignite 2020 was more around the digital transformation, but also the well-being of people at work. And of course, a lot of people staying home, and Microsoft have pointed out some really interesting statistics. Apparently from their studies, they show that commutes can serve as a meaningful transition at the beginning and end of the work day. And that is a reflection that we can do during that time can increase productivity by 12 to 15%. So at the beginning of 2021, they're making efforts to improve how the experience works. And you'll be able to do what's called a virtual commute. So essentially, you'll be able to structure your day so you can have a productive morning and be able to disconnect in the evening. And they've got some interesting ideas about that. For example, creating a little bit of a routine through the application. So you would open your software in the morning and be able to start the day using one of those updates. So they've also announced a partnership with HEADSPACE, which comes into play with virtual commute. So apparently, if you're a remote worker or whether you're a first-line worker, it'll aim to de-stress you by giving you a meditation during the day. It sounds like they've invested a lot into this, and that will become part of your virtual commute, obviously totally optional. So apparently they've also introduced a new stay connected experience inside of Teams. Apparently this is aiming to strengthen relationships with colleagues that are working remotely. And apparently you'll be able to praise top collaborators for key achievements and schedule one-to-one catch-ups. And it also stay connected with your Outlook inside of tasks and emails as well, and help improve that engagement between you and your staff members. They also are going to introduce, near to the start of the day, and individuals will be able to receive a daily briefing email from Cortana, which includes key productivity insights, personal productivity insights, and suggest tasks for the day right in the Outlook inboxes. And apparently this will be generally available beginning in September. They've also made a few modifications in terms of the security side of stuff. They're announcing unifying solutions across Microsoft 365 security and Azure security to deliver the most comprehensive extended detection and response on the market. Apparently everything from applications, infrastructure and emails, cloud platforms will all be much stronger. So in terms of the managerial side of stuff, they've integrated into Endpoint Manager, previously announced as Endpoint Analytics in Productivity Score. This productivity score will be generally available in October, and it will focus on two core areas, the employee experience and the technology experience, so that you can basically get a productivity score for the day for that side of stuff. A productivity score for your employees will also introduce three new categories. Two new employee experience categories focus on meetings and teamwork to help leaders understand best practices and technologies that help ensure inclusive, consistent and effective ways for people to work together. So something I'll probably do another feature on is they're announcing a new Microsoft Outlook on Mac, and it's built on the Microsoft Sync technology, but it brings updates across Mail, Search, Calendar, People, improving the design, much nicer design in terms of the updated experience, and that I'll go into more detail in another video. So they're also excited to introduce a new vision for Microsoft Stream, which was a video application in 365. They're rebuilding it to integrate with other applications so that you can create, share, and discover video that is available in your Office documents. So for example, if you wanna see your video experience inside of SharePoint. So they are phasing that introduction to new features in Stream, but you'll be able to get a bit of a better experience for your videos. So folks, those are the major updates. Apparently this summer, Microsoft launched an initiative to help 25 million acquire digital skills needed in COVID-19. And in the coming months, they're announcing new learning experience in 365, along with learning opportunities designed for employees across your organization. So some quite interesting updates, quite a lengthy update from Microsoft, but definitely something, it seems like they're actually appreciating remote working as a effective solution in the future. And of course, as we have this virus going around, they're paying more attention to it. So folks, I hope you enjoyed this update of Keep Productive News. If you're watching here, here's a little bit more about ClickUp. So folks, this month here on Keep Productive is one of my highly recommended project management tools, and that is ClickUp. Now, ClickUp is one of the fastest growing productivity and project management platforms in the last 2 years, and it's only been around for 2 years. They already have millions of users, and over 100,000 teams are using them at the world's best companies like Google, Airbnb, Uber, and Nike. Now, teams traditionally use spreadsheets, email, chat, and many project managers, but there's a big trend towards teams using just one application. Most teams replace three or more apps just by switching to ClickUp. So that process in itself, moving into one application, saves teams so much time. Now, ClickUp has features like tasks, docs, and goals to keep organized in one place and have fewer meetings, emails, and daily switches between multiple applications. And it's perfect for all types of teams, from 2 to 2,000, and from farming projects to even building aeroplanes. On top of that, they have an extremely generous free forever plan. You can literally add unlimited users and unlimited work to their app for free. So guys, you can find out more about ClickUp below. I recommend checking them out. They also do have a Just Me plan if you wanted to switch to some of your own personal work too. So thanks again to ClickUp for sponsoring this month here on Keep Productive. Thank you very much, folks, and please do make sure you subscribe to the podcast too.